Hello, Apple Valley High School Fab Lab students. It's Mr. Lee, and today what I want to do is show you how to set up a file for printing on our UV printer. So the first thing I'm going to do is open up our template that I've created for making a 4x3 printed acrylic piece. And that's going to be in your Schoology folder for this project. I've already downloaded it to my desktop, so I'm going to go File, Open, and then look for my UV printer 4x3 template and open that up. And what you'll notice is that I set this so that the 4 inches is the width and the depth is 3 inches. You can rotate this 90 degrees if you want to have it in portrait mode. I have it in landscape mode. So now what I'm going to do is go into Chrome, and I search for anime characters because they tend to have lots of colors, and this is a really good image that I found. So I'm going to right click on that image and do Save Image As, and I want to make sure it's a JPEG because using Illustrator with JPEGs is a better way to do that. I'm going to just change the file name to UV printer picture so that I can find it faster. One thing that happens too is big file names tend to mess up the machines. So now what I'm going to do is go into Adobe Illustrator, and I'm going to place that image. So I go to File, Place, and there's my image. I'm going to place that, and it doesn't really matter where I place it, because what I'm going to do next is I'm going to image trace that. There is a little bit of pixelation, but that'll go away hopefully and not distort it too much. So I'm going to do a high fidelity photo, and it's just warning me that it might take a while. The bigger the image, the longer it takes to capture it. Once that's done, I still have to expand it. And then what I'm going to do is get it to fit in that 4x3 box that was created. And you notice that that 4x3 template has a black line. The printer will probably want to print that black line, so I'm going to take that black line away once I get things set. And then anything that's white, we have to tell the machine to print white. We actually have white ink that prints. So this is done now. It did pixelate. It did kind of change the image a little bit, but it's going to be so small that we won't probably notice it. So I'm going to hit expand. And then I've already opened up my template or my window for the transform so I can change the size. But if you go to window and then scroll down to transform, you might have to hit the down arrow to do that on a smaller screen size. So I'm going to select that still and isolate it, because what I want to do is change the size of just this image. And right now it looks like I want to go into my layers so that I just select the image. So I'm going to turn off this for a minute. This is the rectangle. And then I'm going to select this and resize it. You see it's 35 by 17. So my width, I've got to be a little bit less than 4 inches. So I'm going to go 3.9. And then I'm going to put it at 0, 0 for right now. So if you look up here now, it's at 0, 0. It's 1.95 inches in height and 3.9 inches long. So now I'm going to move this just a little bit. So I'm going to turn back on my a rectangle and then place this inside of it. So I'm going to select that group, move it inside. Looks like that's going to fit pretty well. Now, the other thing I want to do, I don't want my whole rectangle to be white. So I'm going to select just this size and make a rectangle behind it that I'm going to change to white, or to the specific thing that I need for printing white. So I'm going to go up to this rectangle tool, and I'm going to put in these dimensions, 3.9 and 1.95. So I'm going to select off that, and I hit the rectangle tool, and then I'm going to type in 3.9 for my width and 1.95 for my height, and create that. Right now, there's no border, so the stroke is zero, but the fill is white. Well, I need to have a fill that is a particular swatch that we're going to add to make sure the printer prints white. So I'm going to go to the select tool, and then I'm going to go to swatches under window, and I'm going to open up that other library. So that's, here's my swatch window, and I'm going to go to Roland VersaWorks. And when that opens up, when we did the print and cut, we had this for doing the cut contour. The next one over tells the machine to print white. So I'm going to bring the fill to the front, and then I'm going to hit this. It turns it gray, but it's really not gray. It's actually telling the machine to print white. And so what I'm going to do now is move this so that it's right behind and right over the colored image. Then what I can do is go into my layers, and in layers I can change and move this gray layer below the colored layer, and now it'll print white first and then print all the colors on top of it. And it looks like I've centered it pretty well. I might select both of those groups and then just kind of move it up a little bit in my, I'm using the arrow key to do that. And that actually looks pretty good. So a couple more things that I have to do to get this ready to print on our EV printer. One thing that I have to do is, if I leave this huge 6x6 inch workspace, the printer thinks it's got to print all that. The other thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to get rid of this black border, because the printer will think it's got to print that too. We just want to print the image. So I'm going to turn this off. I'm going to go into my layers and turn off that rectangle. So I'm going to hide it. Then the next thing I'm going to do is go to Object, Artboards, Fit to Artwork Bounds. And so now the only thing that is there is the colored image. And then I'm going to save that as a PDF file. So I have, instead of Adobe Illustrator, I have it selected to Adobe PDF. It'll add this tag on the end. So I'm going to hit save, and then save again. And now that is ready for printing on the UV printer. So have a nice day.